What is going on today, guys? We are back for another episode in Night of the Dead. Now, before we even get started getting our horde base and everything like that ready to go, what we're going to do is we're going to go do a little bit of looting. We're going to go grab up some cars and stuff quick. We need to get ourselves a little bit more plastic. I would like to get a couple more of these made up. We also need to drop down some more foundations and get a couple other benches made up. We still need to make our cooking bench. And then we also need to make our research table. So that's going to be the plan. We're going to go out. We're going to get a little bit of loot here quick before it gets dark. And then I'll probably do a little bit of the resource grind off camera to get some more logs and stuff like that made up. But anyway, let's go get right to it here before it starts to get dark. We only have a few hours before the horde comes. So we're going to make the best of it with getting some vehicles, maybe hit up a building quick. So for those of you guys who do not know, I do stream this game normally every other day on Twitch. If you guys want to come catch it live and see the action there, I normally stream around 10 and 10 a.m. Central Standard Time. So if you guys want to come out and join for that, there will always be a link in the description box below, which will send you to my Twitch channel. And also, there's also a link for the Discord channel, which also. If you guys join in there, I always post when I'm gonna go live on there so you guys can know exactly what time I'll be live. So anyway, back to the action. We do have what should be a bear spawn over on this side. Now, whether or not the bear is exactly in that area, I'm not sure about. That looks like a special zombie. I believe that is the butcher right there. So we want to give him a wide berth for now. We don't need to kill him off right now, because we're not gonna go up there and mess with his loot or his area at the moment. We just need to get some more simple kind of stuff for now. Just kill off whatever we can with the. Oh, I think we aggroed him. Oh, nope, we aggroed this guy. There we go. Thought we might have aggroed the butcher, which wouldn't have been what we wanted, but it would have worked out okay if we would have. But he does take a bit to kill, that's for sure. He takes tons of hits. Just pump these guys full of arrows. Does take a few hits. Until you upgrade your weapons and stuff, it does take a significant amount of hits. Once we get the research table in, we'll be able to research basically doing more damage to the zombies and the animals. So then they go down a lot faster as well. Now we don't have a lot of inventory room, thanks to the fact that, we're basically waiting to make our storage crates so we can drop stuff off. Now what we could do is we could go back, we could set up our other foundations, and because we have gotten a little bit of rubber now, and then research. I think it's, oh, I can't remember the name of it. Oh, by the way, if you run your stamina bar too far down, as you saw there, you do get a nice little bit of a health drop from it. Ooh, I thought I hit that. Oh, I just took out my small animal trap. Wait. I hit the rabbit, but okay. I'm not sure how that happened then, but apparently I just killed my small animal trap. Which, not a big deal, there are only some pretty basic resources, but that was interesting. Interesting to say the least. But alright, so we need to knock down, or we need to knock out a couple more foundations here. We should be able to place our cook bench right here at the end of this. And then place our research bench straight across on this side here. So, whoops. Let's actually get into the right thing here. The research table takes two wooden planks and a couple more nails for us to craft that. So we're going to work on that first. Grab two of them there. and just walk over here, grab ourselves a couple more planks. Oops, and I fell off. Get back up here now, and eventually I will fill in this with more foundations. We are going to have a bunch of storage chests, and we will work on upgrading them as we go. Whenever we basically have the materials for it, we will work on doing that right away, because we're going to have a lot of stuff. I'm running 5 upgraded storage chests on stream, and some of them are pretty full. Some of them have a bit of room right now, but it does take a lot. But anyway, we'll get into that more later. But what we want is we want the junior engineer, because that allows us to make plastic, allows us to make rubber rings, and it allows us to make tape. Now, the plastic is going to be important for our storage chest. Tape is going to be important for the +2 upgrade of weapons. Now, we can also take a point into blacksmith, which is, will allow us to craft the following items. And it also gives us the ability to upgrade our weapons to +4. So that's a decent start as far as that goes. Now there's tons of other skills in here we could go ahead and look into getting. One that I think is really important is getting Novus Porter, because it gives you +12 inventory space. Another thing that's very important for me is getting the research for the harvesting, because you end up doing a lot of harvesting, you do a lot of building, you need a lot of the basic materials, so that just helps it go quicker. Animal Hunter, Zombie Hunter, both are really good ones to get. You're going to need Engineer, of course, to make more traps, and then Blacksmith will allow you to make new weapons, get your weapons upgraded further, and then eventually get to the lightsaber and the ability to go to +10 on your weapons. Now for me personally, 1 point into cook is fine for now for the roasted pork feet, but again, that stuff we'll get to a little bit later. Junior builder is a very nice one to have. And again, 2 points into porter does you pretty good for quite a while, because it'll expand an additional 4 rows. But anyway, we got that all knocked out for now. So now what we can do is we can make up some plastic here, which you can take all your plastic pieces and turn it into plastic if you want. Save you a little time later on. Personal preference, really. Cloth pieces only make cloth as far as I've found, so you can turn all your cloth pieces right into cloth. Just to kind of save on room as well. So anyway, now we can go ahead and we can drop down a couple of these once we get some nails and some more planks made up. So I'm going to do a couple little bits of quick harvesting on some trees, and then I'll be back to you guys to make up a couple more storage chests and get our loot sorted out. Alright, so I did a little bit of harvesting. I got our other foundations placed down. What we need to do now is we just need to get ourselves a little bit of planks. I got the nails done already. But all we're going to need is we're going to need 4 planks, because we're only going to make 2 more chests for right now, because we're low on iron at the moment. But just make up 4 planks. The nice thing about this game is there's no crafting timer. You go in, you pop the stuff, punch the stuff in that you want, and you're good to go. Now the animals, as you can see, they're still here, so we will harvest them up as soon as we are done with this. I don't know how long animals stay on the map. Same with like the bags that the zombies drop. I'm not sure if there's like a timer on them and they disappear after a certain amount of time or what. But anyway, we got our 2 other chests placed down. So our first one is always going to be for food. Our second one is always going to be for bones and skins. So we could just drop all these skins in here. The feathers as well will all go in there as the same. And then this one's going to be for like our crafting materials. Not like our basic materials like wood, stone, stuff like that. This is going to be for like our cloth, wire, plastic, rubber, plate, ingots, our other trap machines, which we'll be using the trap machine in a little bit. But basically stuff like that. Stuff you don't harvest from the earth, I guess I'll call it. So basically that's the stuff that's going to end up going there. And then our fourth chest is going to be from the stuff that we harvest from, again, the earth, I guess. And then the last one will be for like our extra equipment, weapons, ammo, stuff like that will go in there. So anyway, what we got to do now is we got to figure out where we want our horde base, how we want to set it up, and get some more resources harvested. So my thought is I'm gonna place my horde base probably right out there. The horde base is gonna be rather large, so it is gonna take a bit of space. Now, unfortunately, the only light we have right now is this, and it's normally either too bright or it's too dark. So it is what it is. I will be making some lights on our horde base. I will put in some of the torch things once we get it up and running. But anyway, I'm not sure what exactly the deal with our small animal trap is. It just kind of disappeared on us, for lack of a better way to put it. So I really don't know. Don't know what to say about that. It's just kind of, I think we hit it with an arrow or whatnot, and it just kind of grenaded apart on us. So we're gonna clear a little bit of area out here. Like I said, our horde base is gonna be rather large, so unfortunately we are kind of close to that building there, and then we have our main base set up, so we gotta kind of plan it out right because we are gonna need a decent amount of room for it. I think what we're gonna do is we're actually gonna make it so our stairs leading up are going to be on this side here, closest to our horde base or our main base, and then we'll put the biggest part of our horde base out that way because we have more room out there, so that should work out all right. The only thing we're going to have to do is we are going to have to build our horde base up rather high. And the reason for that is the slope of the ground. The slope goes up, so we're gonna have to start it out pretty high. And maybe we will have to do double foundations on it. It's hard to say. But turn the light on, see if that helps a little bit with the with being able to see. But we're gonna start it right about here. So go ahead, we're gonna grab a couple foundations. Now it's gonna start out small and eventually we will make it bigger as we go, but we're gonna wanna start it out, I think, at this height because that's gonna be just above ground level over there. So I know it looks like it's quite high up, but in all honesty, it's not going to be for long. So as you can see, the further we get over here, the lower it's going to end up being. So we got them done. We need to put in stairs now. So good thing we got stairs that can go up quite a distance, just like that. And that's basically at max height without putting in a second foundation underneath it. So this is going to be how our horde base comes in. You're going to come up and then we're going to put down pendulum trap in the first three blocks here. So the pendulum trap is what we need to do for the quest there. It's in melee traps here, and then we're gonna have to go get everything we need for it yet. So we're gonna need iron ingot, lumber, wooden planks, our trap machine, 10 rope, and 5 nails. So we will have pretty much all of that. The only thing we're gonna be shy on is the iron. We don't have enough. Well, we have 7, so we're gonna have, let me correct myself, we're gonna have just enough in order to make that. So let's get some stuff dropped off here first before we even work on that. We're gonna drop off our food stuff, our bones and skins. And that's about it for now. We do need a little bit more lumber because we gotta make some planks. That's kind of, the first couple days are a little bit of a grind getting basic materials up and running, but it goes pretty quick. I mean, especially once you get the research for harvesting stuff, then as far as the grind goes for getting stuff like this, it's quick. It goes really fast. You can plow through a whole area of everything in a matter of, no time at all. Upgrade your axe, upgrade the mining skills, and you're good to go. So right now I think it takes 6 hits or 5 hits per tree. I think it depends on the size, and eventually it will only take a couple hits. It will go quick. But we're gonna need to get small animal traps reset up because apparently We destroyed ours, which I still want to know how that happened. I'm just not sure about hitting it with an arrow and a thing like took off like that was kind of funny, but at the same time, it's like, how'd that even work? You know, just kind of funky that way, I guess. But got a couple more hours till the horde comes in, so just kind of clearing up some stuff, getting some more seeds, because we're gonna need, I think it's 3 seeds per small animal trap. But anyway, so what we need to get is, check our little list here, is we need to get 10 rope and our trap machine and an iron ingot from this chest. So trap machine, iron ingot, and of course we don't have any rope, but we do have a nice bit of cloth. So we're going to turn all this cloth we have on us into rope, just like that. And then we need, whoops, while we're right here, we can grab the 5 nails that we needed, just like that. Now we need the planks and the lumber. So we need 4 of each, which is just 4 lumber, 4 planks. We don't need any logs or any other kind of wood for this. So we could just come here and make 4 of them. And make sure you don't get the trim logs. You want the actual lumber. And get them done, just like so. Whoops. Accidentally hit B. And then we're going to come up here and get our pendulum placed down. Now, to start out with, for the first little bit, the pendulum is plenty. But as the nights go on, the hordes get a lot rougher. They really do. They get considerably rougher. You'll start to see special zombies coming in. It's a lot of fun, don't get me wrong, but it increases in difficulty pretty quickly. So just keep that in mind. Now, the other thing I want to do is I want to get a wall light. We need 1 fuel, 1 trim log, 1 iron ingot, and 2 nails. Now, this is going to be the last of our iron until we go scrap down some cars, scrap down those metal barrels, refrigerators in a house, or find an actual iron boulder out there. Because you can see these ones are kind of gray. Those are just your normal rock ones. You'll find ones that look almost black. And those are the ones that you want. So, gonna grab the nails. We need a trim log. Now, do we have the ability to make fuel? Yes, we just need our oil. Do we have... There we go. Just need 1 of them. That'll turn into 10 fuel. And let's see here. We need... Oh yeah, 1 iron ingot. Just like that. Now we can go place down our light, so we'll have some great lighting for the first night. That's one thing that I kind of like to do for making videos, is make sure that the lighting is good. Otherwise, you know, ends up looking not so great. So anyway, you can place these on the side of the traps. They can be a little bit fussy sometimes placing them, but you drop it down and boom, look at how lit up that is. Turn off our flashlight and you can see for quite a while. But anyway, guys, I'm going to work on some resource grinding while we wait for the horde to start. When the wave gets to start, I'll be back to you guys so we can get going and slay the night of zombies. All right, so we've got a bunch of stuff all harvested up here. So as you can see, the area is a bit cleaner now. I spent a bit of time, and like I said, I got a bunch of stuff harvested up. So we got plenty of branches, we got a decent stockpile of logs now, and we got some boulders. So what we want to do is we have 13 seeds now, so we can make ourselves a couple small animal traps quick. I'm going to put them on this side. Hopefully I don't shoot the thing this time. But again, I'm not sure how that tore it apart. But I guess it happened. So anyway, we're going to make 4 of these up. I like to have 4 of these. And Horde Night is just starting now. As you guys can see, the skull and crossbones is completely, the circle is completely covered around it. And the time is at 0 hours. So that means Horde Night is starting. Now you do get a little bit of time before it actually starts. I mean, it's not like as soon as the time hits, you know, you gotta rush to your base. You get a few minutes. There's other zombies around as well, so we'll have plenty of stuff to kill off here. Just gonna drop off whatever we can in here. As you guys can see, we do have some extra stuff that still needs to go in here. And as far as upgrading it goes, all you need is a rubber ring, one iron ingot, four nails, and four plate. Now, the hardest thing I found to get is the plate. I mean, other than that, everything's pretty simple to get. The rest of it's not too bad to get a hold of. So plate is kind of like the only thing that is more so challenging to get. And it's not even that hard to get. You just got to go loot buildings for it and stuff like that. So anyway, Horde Night is starting. Now, the zombies will all come from basically one direction. And as you can see, they'll be running at you. So you'll know exactly where they're going to be coming from. Once you see one coming from a direction, you'll know where they're spawning. Now, the farther you get out that way, the farther away the zombies are just going to keep spawning over there. So this guy doesn't want to take like an aim punch. That's one thing with the zombies. If you're hitting them, they can still hit you. But if they're hitting you, you cannot swing back. And they're pretty easy to miss in this third person view. And for some reason, the bow likes to shoot an extra round or an extra arrow out when you aim sometimes. So just take note of that. Like, oh, one come from behind us. He's not part of the Horde wave. He was just one that was out here walking around. So you can hear every so often when I go to aim that an arrow comes out. And one thing is, the zombies like to walk in the compass direction. So if you'll note, like if we get out here in a goofy angle from them, you'll see they'll pace over to the side to come like from the north or something like that from us. So they do walk kind of like how they do in 7 Days to Die, where they're in a, like a pretty basic design for pathing. As you can see, he walked all the way over there to get towards us. So now if you get a bunch of them behind you, or you just don't want to, you know, waste your ammo on killing them, just walk them up into your pendulum. Do not be under the pendulum when it comes down. It will hit you, and it won't always kill the zombies. They'll sneak through it, as you can see. So, oh, I missed. Now, yes, we could use the knife to attack them. The knife does work okay, but as far as melee weapons go, the knife isn't the best. It is very fast, but like I said, you're not able to, for lack of a better term, aim punch the zombies. So you can see she's hitting me while I'm hitting her, but when she hits me, I can't swing back. Why that is, I honestly can't say. I think if the zombies are able to do that to you, you ought to be able to do it back to them. You ought to be able to hit them and stun lock them. There we go. I'll call it stun lock, not aim punch. I'll call it stun lock. That sounds like a better term for it. So now, in between when the zombies come, you can take the time to go harvest. I mean, you can see the zombie coming on the left side there from by the car. So you can take the time to go harvest. I mean, it all depends on what you got to do, how comfortable you are with fighting the zombies. And, you know, there's nothing wrong with sitting in your Horde base and waiting for him to come through your pendulum, which I'll show you something with that here in just a minute. So when the pendulum goes down, it does take away from the count. As you can see, 26 out of 30. You do need to reload it with tree branches for it to function. When it gets down to 0 of 30, it won't swing anymore. So just keep that in mind. Now the zombies will tend to run away from you when you're hitting them a little bit. Not because they're like actually running from you, but sometimes with the special zombies, they run away to do their special attack. You'll have like ones that'll come charging at you. You'll have ones that'll jump at you. The butcher throwing axes at you. So they have various different things that they'll actually do. And not all zombies will do the same thing. Not all zombies are even special zombies. And some of the, again, it's kind of a loose term I'll use is special zombie, but some of them, there's really three kinds of special zombies. There is the butcher, and then you'll find, depending on what you'd like to call it, the tank or the charger is the one is what we've been calling it on stream. He just comes running at you and will do that special running attack. And then there's also a spider, which blows up. But anyway, as you guys can see, this is the big wave that comes. Now, for the first night, as you can see, there's really not a lot. There's only eight of them in this wave, so there's not a ton. You could stand there and you could kill them off, or you can just run up into here and let the pendulum have a little bit of fun with them. So yes, some of them will get through, and when they do, you can either jump off, run them back through, or you can hit them with your knife, hit them with your bow, whatever you'd like to do. But anyway, that's the whole Horde Night. Once the big wave comes, that's it. Later on, you might have a couple different big waves, but for the most part, for the first night, or first 2 nights rather, once you get the big wave, that's done. Now, as far as conditioning goes, if you can see on the top left of the screen, you'll see the health bar, the stamina bar, and the condition bar. You'll notice we've lost four chunks. Now, as you go throughout the day, you need to eat. So, conditioning does not come from all foods. It actually, when you, we'll actually set up our cooking bench so I can show you some of the cooking recipes quick. But some foods only give health back. Like the apple here, some foods actually take away health because you have to cook them first. Like the mushrooms take away health and conditioning. The egg takes away 10 health. Fruits give you a little bit of health back. The white mushroom actually does give you health back. Brown mushroom as well, and the red mushroom takes it away. Other fruits will just give you a little bit of health back. But in order to get conditioning back, especially early on, you use energy bars. They give plus 50 health, plus 20 conditioning. That's two of the small bars in the conditioning bar itself. That's what that'll give you back. So early on, the energy bars are fantastic. Later on, you'll be able to get different cooking recipes and stuff like that. Let's actually check some of this out quick. Put this up in here just like that, and you can see, like with the mushrooms, you can make them so they give you back plus 10 health. These are great for just recovering health when you're out looting and take some hits. Boiled eggs give you 5 health. The large meats, or basically any of the cooked meats, will give you conditioning back. As you can see, bird meat gives you 10, large meat gives you 20, the regular meat size gives you 10. Roasted meat will give you 10 as well. Roasted mushrooms and fruits together. Now, this is the combination of basically everything, with the exception of the blueberries and the cherries, will give you back plus 10 and 30. These also are great for just a little bit of health. Now, one of the things that I like to get right away is the ability to craft roasted pig feet. Now, the reason for this is it gives you 20 conditioning and 75 health back, but for 1 full day, you get an extra chunk on your bar. So it gives you 10 max conditioning more. Now, there's other recipes that give you some pretty good stuff. Again, roasted good meat like this. Obviously, you need to research for it, but it gives you back 30 conditioning and gives you the 10 bonus as well. So you just need a piece of the good meat in order to do that. Now, again, there's more recipes as you upgrade the bench. So you'll have like the baguette and other stuff like that. 20 max conditioning for 1 day for roasted bacon, which is you take bacon and then you add garlic, orange, and cooking oil to it. and 20 max conditioning for one day. Bacon gives you, takes away health, but gives you conditioning. Cooking oil, you got cookies, meat stew, broth, veggie stew, sausage. There's even more here. So you got the steak platter. 100 condition, 100 health, 40 max condition for one day. That is incredible. That's four extra chunks. That is huge. So as you can see, as you go further in, we will be able to craft some pretty nice stuff. However, is it necessary? I mean, you guys can be the judge of that. It's, you know, it's really up to you whether you think it's absolutely necessary to make the stuff or not. But now some stuff, like the carrot, I believe comes specifically, same with the potato, comes from making the farm plots on here. So, or rather the farm in the cooking, or no, utility, my bad. So making the farm, obviously, as you guys can see, does take a bit of stuff. And you obtain various food ingredients from it, is what it says. I have not got to making these yet, so I don't know about them. We will probably be making these on stream potentially tomorrow. If we do end up streaming tomorrow, it's going to depend on how the day goes. But this will be something we are going to look into doing. They are expensive with seeds, so you got to take down a lot of bushes, a lot of trees in order to get seeds. But, you know, it is well worth it. We got two fox already in the traps. We need rabbits for our upgrades. But anyway, guys, that's going to do it for this video. Next episode, we're going to be going out. We're going to be looting some of the compounds around the area. I'll shut the light off so you guys can see out there a little bit. We're probably going to head to the west, I think. And we'll start looting over there. We might take on the butcher, depending on how we feel. And we do have the one rabbit skin and rabbit bone. So what we'll do is we will do our first upgrade in the next video, and then we'll go out and do a little bit of looting from there. So anyway, guys, thank you so much for being here. I really do appreciate it. If you guys are enjoying the videos, make sure you guys take the time to hit that like button. Comment down below if you have any questions and want to see anything in the game. If I'm forgetting to mention anything, let me know in the comment section down below. If you guys, like I mentioned earlier, if you guys do want to come over and see the stream live, make sure you guys click the link below to come over to Twitch. Check it out with me. I stream for about 2 hours per game that I do. So if you guys want to come over and check that out, a lot of fun. Just come over and chat, say hello, and or just sit there, lurk, and watch the stream. It's up to you guys. If you guys want, there's also a link to the Discord in the description below as well. Come on over to Discord. You guys can help me iron out a good schedule for streaming. And let me know all your thoughts there. I also post in Discord exactly when I go live on Twitch. So then you guys will know every day when I go up to stream. So anyway, thank you guys again so much for being here. And we'll catch you guys back for the next video.